What a dooski, guys. It's Farewell 34 and welcome back to another all-new Kingsman Universe topic video. So for this one, we're going to take a look at the comic book, The Secret Service, and more specifically, we'll be taking a look at the major differences from the comic to the movie. So let's get right into it. So probably one of the biggest changes from the comic to the film is the name and the idea of the Kingsman. The comic is called The Secret Service, and the organization, instead of being a private group, is the MI6, the real-life British intelligence agency. However, in the movie, they are instead an independent spy intelligence agency called the Kingsmen. Another addition was the whole idea of being based off of the Knights of the Round Table. This, along with the other gadgets, code names, and attire, were more originated for the movie, including the signature Manners Maketh Man. Another big difference in the comic from the movie is there isn't the whole idea of the Lancelot and the position needing to be filled. The comic, however, does include a spy training camp, but it's really just meant to straighten out Eggsy and get him to become a spy, plus we don't spend any time getting to know some of the other people at this training camp. Speaking of the spy camp, there's a significant difference in terms of time. Whereas in the movie, it brushes over time pretty quickly, over presumably a couple of months, the spy camp in the comics takes place over 3 years. With regards to the villain, this is probably one of the things that changed quite a bit. The villain in the comic was named Dr. James Arnold. Now, this name may sound familiar as he is in the movie as well, but there are a couple of differences. The first one is, in the comics, the beginning scene both have Mark Hamill. However, in the comics, the beginning scene has Mark Hamill as well. However, it's actually the actor Mark Hamill, and he dies along with the agent, plus Professor Arnold gets upset. In the movie, Samuel L. Jackson plays a villain who is essentially the comic book version of Dr. Arnold and is renamed Richmond Valentine. Other than that, and the fact that the comic version of Arnold and the movie look different, their motives are the same. The villain's goal in the comic is to fix the population problem, just as the one in the movie, and both use the same plan of the exploding SIM cards. However, one interesting twist from the comic that wasn't translated into the movie is the idea of who is saved. As we know in the movie, the people who are saved are the rich, powerful, and the wealthy. What's interesting and actually explains the idea that Mark Hamill is in the beginning of the comic is Dr. James Arnold wants to save only his favorite actors from franchises that he loves. One, for instance, would be Star Wars, thus why Mark Hamill, aka Luke Skywalker, is in the beginning. Now moving on to some character changes, there are a few significant alterations in character roles for the movie, one of the biggest being Colin Firth's character. In the movie, he's called Harry Hart and has no relation to Eggsy apart from him working with his now dead father after his life was saved by him and he feels responsible. In the comic, Harry Hart is actually called Jack London and has a direct relationship to Eggsy, that is, he is his deadbeat rich uncle who's never around. In addition, in the comics, Eggsy is called by his first name instead of his nickname in the movie, Eggsy, which is Gary. In the comics, Jack only gets Gary out of his difficult situation and eventually helps his sister, Gary's mom, out of her financial and domestic issues to make up for his absence in her life. Another big difference is, in the comic, they really play up this aspect of family, and we really don't get that in the movie. Now, in the movie instead, Harry comes into Eggsy's life looking to help him after the favor he made to him when he was a child when he's in danger. Another character who's quite different is Gazelle. The character of Gazelle is very different in the comics than the badass woman that we see in the movie. In fact, Gazelle isn't even a woman in the comics, but a man that resembles Valentine in the movie. In the comics, Roxy isn't in the spy camp as well. Instead, she is an addition to the movie that's an integral character and brings a strong female character into the story. As I just mentioned, Gazelle from the comics was actually gender and race swapped and essentially replaces the character of Ambrosia Chase from the comics, who's Dr. Arnold's girlfriend that Jack London ends up sleeping with. As well, Gazelle doesn't have the same sore prosthetic legs that we see in the movie, but the character is still a threat due to being a former Secret Service agent. So now I'm going to run over some other small or other instances of some changes. Something in the comics that's not in the movie is a bunch of other awesome action sequences, and I was actually quite surprised that they didn't put these in the movie, probably for budgetary reasons, because a lot of them are actually pretty large in scale. So the comic actually has many more that weren't adapted. For instance, in the beginning, there's a large snowmobile sequence at the base after it explodes, with some really cool kills. As well, in the comic, there's a test trial for the chip, just like the church scene in the movie. However, it's done in a group wedding in Hawaii. In the movie, the test trial by Valentine takes place in an aggressive church environment, and instead of being light-toned and almost funny, it's much more gory in the film. Something similar is we see this idea of Valentine's satellite, and an agent has to go to the edge of the Earth's atmosphere to take care of it. While in the movie, it actually slows down Valentine's plans, in the comic book, the space balloons actually mess up and drastically affect Dr. Arnold's weapon. So instead of the machine getting people to kill each other, what it does instead is creates 19 minutes of world peace. Pretty much in this sequence, we just see a bunch of people all around the world kissing each other, coming together, and being kind to each other. And guys, that is my my video on the differences from the Kingsman comic versus the movie. What did you guys think? Let me know your thoughts in the comments section down below. This may not have been every little detail that's different from the comics and the movies, but I tried covering the most that I could. If there's anything else you guys want to mention, feel free to mention them in the comments section down below. As always, if you enjoyed this video, then be sure to leave a like and subscribe to the Hybrid Network if you haven't already. I'm Farewell34. I'll see you guys next time. Take care.